Hello students of class 8. So already I have discussed the exercise 8.3 with you. So please try to solve the question like that only we have to solve in exercise 8.4 also. So please try to do the questions. Okay. Some of you have already shared the answers with me, but please try to do the questions. Okay. And you first of all see the questions of this chapter, that is simple linear equation. These questions will become only as a word problem to you. And first of all, you have to understand the word problem. Then you have to form the equation. After forming the equation, you have to solve that equation to find the value of unknown. So there are many steps. So what are the steps? First of all, you have to read the question properly. You have to understand it. This is the first step. And in second step, you have to form the equation using that given condition. You have to form the equation. And lastly, you have to solve this equation to find the value of unknown. Okay. So here in exercise 8.4 also, we have to simplify the equation again. Okay. So the topic of this exercise is more applications. Already we have studied the application of simple linear equation in exercise 8.3, but here also we have to study more about it. Okay, so I am starting exercise 8.4. See the exercise, the questions are many. See, 14 questions are there. So today I am going to discuss only half part of it, and in the next video lecture I am going to discuss the next part. Okay, so try to do the questions which I am giving you as a home task. Okay, so let us start this exercise. So see the first question here. First question is not very tricky, but see, you have to read the question very carefully. You have to understand the question. Okay, so first is a 60 liter solution of alcohol and water. That means a solution is present, and in that solution there are two things. First one is alcohol and second is water. Okay, so it contains 20 liters of alcohol. That means a 60 liter solution contains 20 liters of alcohol. Okay, next is, how much alcohol must be added to produce a solution of 50% alcohol? Okay, so how much alcohol must be added to that solution so that we can get a solution which contains what? Which contains 50% alcohol. So see how to do this. First of all, you have to write the given condition. See, total solution, it is written, total solution is 60 liter. Okay, then alcohol present in the solution is what? 20 liter alcohol is present in the solution of 60 liter. Okay, so next is what we have to find. We have to find the amount of alcohol which must be added to that solution so that at last 50% of the solution contains alcohol. Okay, 50% of alcohol should be present in the solution. This is at last. Okay, that means after adding, okay, after adding x liter of alcohol, we should get what? 50% of alcohol. At last we should get 50% of alcohol. So see, let x liter of alcohol must be added to that solution so that we can get 50% of alcohol. So see, the alcohol present in the solution at last will be how much? See, now it is 20 liter, it is given, but if we add x liter of alcohol, then at last how much alcohol should be present in the solution? Yes, that will be what? X plus 20, because we have to add x to what? 20. 20 was the previous amount of alcohol, and the last amount of alcohol will be what? X plus 20. Similarly, if the amount of alcohol is increased in the solution, then the total solution will also get increased. Yes, so the total solution at last will be how much? Yes, previously it was 60 liter, so now it will become how much? Yes, x plus 60. That means we have to add x liter to what? To the solution. So the total solution was 60 liter, now we have to add x to it. Okay, so now see this one. So alcohol at last, how much alcohol will be present? this will be equal to 50% of the total solution. This is already given in the question, okay? That is, how much alcohol must be added to produce a solution of 50% of alcohol. So alcohol at last should be this much. So now you see, alcohol at last already we found here. Alcohol present in the solution at last will be x plus 20. So in the left hand side we have to write x plus 20. This will be 50% of 50%. You can just convert this 50%, that is 50 by 100 of, that means into, and total solution is what? X plus 60. So now you have to solve this equation. So see, this is very simple. Just cancel it. It will become what? 2, 1 by 2. So just transfer 2 to that side. It get multiplied with x plus 20. So 2 into x plus 20, and this will be equal to, here what will happen here, already we have transposed 2 to that side, so here 1 will be remaining into x plus 60. Okay, so next this will become what? 2x plus, when you multiply 2 with 20 you will get 40, is equal to this will be x plus 60. Okay, so transpose x to that side, you will get 2x minus x, and 40 will be transposed to that side, so 60 minus 40. So x is equal to, you will get 20. Okay, so that means 20 liter of alcohol must be added to the solution so that we can produce 50% of alcohol. Okay. So next is question number 2. That is also same type of question like 1. Okay, so please try to do that question. I am doing question number 3. So what is written in question number 3? Length of a rectangle exceeds its width by 4 meter. That means length is greater than its breadth by 4 meter. Okay. So if the breadth is 5 centimeter, then the length will be what? 9 centimeter, because it is 4 more than its breadth. Okay. So if we take the breadth as x meter, then what will be the length? Yes, the length will be what? X added to what? 4. Okay. So length, as you know, length is a bigger quantity. Okay. Length is greater than breadth. So here we are taking breadth of the rectangle as x meter, and perimeter already it is given 40 meter. Okay. So you have to write the given condition. Perimeter is 40 meter. So according to the question, we can write length is equal to 4 is added to its breadth. Okay. X plus 4. This is the length of the rectangle. Okay. So now already perimeter is equal to 40 meter, it is given, and perimeter, the formula of perimeter is 2 into length plus breadth. So you have to apply that formula. So in place of length we can write x plus 4, and in place of breadth we can write x. So in place of breadth I am writing x, and in place of length I am writing x plus 4, and that is equal to 40. So remaining you have to solve the bracket first. So x will be added to x, this will be 2x plus 4 is equal to 40. So just multiply, just apply the distributive property. This will be 4x, 2 4s are 8, is equal to 40. So next see, 4x, when you transpose 8 to that side, so this will be 40 minus 8, this will be 32. Okay, so just write the implied sign, okay, because you are solving an equation. So x will be equal to 32 by 4, cancel it, you will get what? X is equal to 8. What was x? X is our breadth. So if breadth is 8 meter, then what will be the length? Yes, 4 is added to the breadth. So 8 plus 4. So this will be what? 12 meters. So finally you have to write the length and the breadth of the rectangle are 12 meter and 8 meter respectively. So see, the next question is number 4. Already a square is given, and the adjacent side of that square is given. So these are the adjacent side, 4x minus 7, and the other side is given as 3x plus 5. Okay, so we know that all sides of a square are what? They are equal. Okay, therefore we can equate the two expressions. We can write this length will be equal to this length, because already we know that the sides in a square are equal. So we can write 4x minus 7 equal to 3x plus 5. So rest you have to solve, and you have to find the value of x. See, after finding the value of x, don't stop here, because in question they are asking the length of the side of the square. So what will be the length? See, length you can just you can write any of the expression, any one of the expression. You can write 3x plus 5 also, and you can use 4x minus 7 also. So I have used 4x minus 7. Just put the value of x here, you will get the length of the side. You can put x is equal to 12 in this expression also, you will get the same number, that is 41. So therefore 41 is the length of the side of the square. So see the next question. Next question is question number 4. This is a very interesting question. See, one square is given, okay. You know that the side of the square are all what? Same, okay. So this is a square. Okay, we don't know the sides, we don't know the length of any side. Okay, so next, what is given? See, we are increasing the side of this square. By how much? By 2 meter. Okay, by 2 meter we are increasing one side. So if I increase this side by 2 meter, see what will happen. See, this is 2 meter, I am increasing 2 meter. Okay, so this is the like this 2 meter is increased. Okay, 2 meter is increased. Now see what next it is given. Next is given, other side is reduced to 2 meter. That means you have to take the adjacent side. Okay, adjacent side means what? I told you already, adjacent side means the sides which share a common corner, common vertex. Okay, so you have to take this side. So just reduce this side by 2 meters. So I am reducing it. So I am reducing it by 2 meters. So after reducing it by 2 meter, you will get like this. Okay. So now see, this is a what? This is a rectangle. Now this is a rectangle. And what is the perimeter of this rectangle? Perimeter is given 48 meter. Okay. So what we have done? We have increased the side, one side by 2 meter, and we have decreased the other side by 2 meter. Okay. So let us take this side of this square as x meter. So this all are x. So now see, if I am adding 2 to this, 2 to this side, then what will be the length of this new rectangle? Yes, this will be x plus 2 because we are adding 2. And if I reduce the other side, means this side I am reducing it by 2. So if I reduce, I have to subtract 2 from x. So this length will be what? X minus 2. Okay, so that only I have written. Let the side of the original square be x meter. Length will be x plus 2. Breadth will be x minus 2. Okay. So again, one more thing is given. Perimeter of the rectangle is given. That is 48 meter. And we know that the formula of perimeter is 2 into L plus B. So just put L is equal to x plus 2 and breadth is equal to x minus 2. So after opening the bracket, plus 2 minus 2 will become 0. And x plus x will become 2x. And outside the bracket we are having 2, that is from the perimeter formula. Okay, so 2 into 2 will be 4, 4x is equal to 48. Rest, you have to transfer 4 to that side, so it will get divided. So this will become what? 12. So x is what? 12. And what we have to find? We have to find here the length of the original square. So what is the length of the original square? We have taken x, okay, so x, that means length of the original side of the original square is 12. You have to write the unit, that is meter. Okay, they can ask the length of the new rectangle also. Okay, so if they ask that what is the length of the new rectangle, then you have to add 2 to it. Similarly, breadth will be what? You have to reduce 2 from it, so you will get breadth as 10 meter and length as 14 meter. Okay, so next question is question number 6. This is again an interesting question. Okay, so see, there are 2 rectangles given. Okay, just understand the question, just read the question carefully. There are 2 rectangles. So what is given in the first rectangle? It is given that length of the rectangle exceeds its width, that means breadth, by 5 meter. Okay, so according to that we have to take something. Okay, so just take the breadth as x meter. This is what? This is for the original rectangle. That is the old one. Okay. That old rectangle, that was the original rectangle. So breadth, let the breadth is x meter. So according to the first line, the length will be equal to what? The length will be equal to x plus 5 meter. Okay. So what will be the area of that rectangle? original rectangle. Yes, that will be length into breadth. So length into breadth will be, this is length, this is breadth. Okay, we have to multiply this. So this will be x into x will be x square, and plus 5 into x will be 5x, and this comes in meter square. So this is our area for the original, or you can say that old rectangle. Okay, so now come to the new rectangle. What is happening to the new rectangle? See, if the width is increased by 1 meter, that means we have to add 1 to the breadth. So what was our breadth? Breadth was x. We have to add 1 to it. That means this is for the new rectangle. Okay, very simple. Just you have to write properly, you have to read properly. Okay, so the width of the new rectangle will be what? We have to add 1 to it. 1 to the length, sorry, 1 to the breadth of the original rectangle. Okay, so this is the breadth, and what is given for length? And the length is decreased by 2 meter. That means above length was what? X plus 5. That means you have to decrease 2. That means you have to subtract 2 from it. So x plus 5 minus 2. Just open the bracket, you will get 5 minus 2, and that will be 3. So this is the length of the new rectangle. Okay, so now what is given? The next given thing is the area of new rectangle is 4 square meter less than the area of the original rectangle. So you have to subtract 4 meter square from the area of the original rectangle. So area of original rectangle is this one. You have to subtract 4 from it. Okay, already it is written in question. So this is the area of new rectangle. So just write like this. Open the bracket, you will get this one. So what is the area of new rectangle? Already we are having the length and breadth of the new rectangle. Just multiply these two things. This is length, okay? And this one is what? Breadth of the new rectangle. So we have to multiply this one to get the area of new rectangle. So here x plus 3 is the length, and breadth is what? X plus 1. So after multiplying, you will get x square. You know how to multiply it. We have already done in the previous chapter. This will be 4x and plus 3 is equal to x square plus 5x minus 4. See, x square will get cancelled. Then next, just transpose 5x to this side and 3 to that side. So this will be minus x, this will be minus 7. Okay, so from this, you will get what? You will get x is equal to what? 7. Minus minus will get cancelled out. So finally, the value of x will be what? 7. So what we have to find, just see the question. We have to find the dimension of the original rectangle. Dimension, that means length and breadth of the original rectangle. So breadth is what? Breadth was x meter. So that means this is our breadth. So we have found the breadth of the original rectangle. So what will be length? Length will be what? Length already it is given x plus 5. That means we have to add 7 to 5. 7 plus 5 will be what? 12 meter. So these are the dimension of the original rectangle. So students, please try to do the remaining question from 1 to 7. 7 I am giving you as a homework. So from question number 8, I am going to discuss in the next lecture. Okay. So thank you, students.